वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल स्टडी विद सौम्या। मेक श्योर टू सब्सक्राइब दिस चैनल इफ यू हैवंट सब्सक्राइब टिल नाउ। दिस चैनल इज डेफिनेटली गोइंग टू बी हेल्पफुल फॉर यू, सो मेक श्योर टू सब्सक्राइब। ऑल्सो डू ज्वाइन अस एट आवर टेलीग्राम चैनल। जस्ट अ रिमाइंडर दैट व्हेन सब्सक्राइबिंग द चैनल मेक श्योर टू टर्न ऑन द बेल आइकन सो दैट यू डोंट मिस एनी अपडेट और एनी अपॉर्चुनिटी फ्रॉम द चैनल। सो डू सब्सक्राइब द चैनल। Well, as if TCS May and QT is about to approach, so we have decided to make an aptitude series for all of you. For sure, this series is going to be helpful for you because when it comes to TCS, so aptitude is a very, very important section in the TCS. And generally, students got rejected or not able to qualify the first round, that is the written round, because of the aptitude part only. Because the questions are generally range from moderate to difficult level, and sometimes they are easy as well. But timing is a very important issue there, because in a given time you have to solve that particular question. But generally we are not able to manage that time, and this is the case where we do lack. So basically what we will do, so in the first video, in this video I will tell you that what are the topics. See, before starting the preparation of any exam, topic should be clear to you. Just don't directly start solving the question, because maybe a case that you are solving the question of that particular topic from which they are going to ask only one or two question. So is it going to be helpful for you? For sure not. So there always should be a strategy to solve the questions, to understand that how we have to continue our preparation in a particular manner, right? So that is why mainly students do solve the questions, do give time to the aptitude, but they are not following a particular strategy. They are randomly solving, they are randomly preparing any particular topic. So that is for sure not going to be helpful for you. So what we will do in this video, we will first understand the syllabus of aptitude. We will understand that which topic is very, very important. It means that from which topic we can expect most of the questions, from which topic they are going to kind of ask average questions, like is average questions, right? From which topic really questions will be asked. So according to the topics, according to this understanding, we can start our preparation. So the topic which is very, very important, so you have to give your lots of time to that particular topic. And after completing those topics, we will go to the topic from which moderate chances of getting the question. So we will prepare that topic. And from the rarely asked or less occurrences topic, what we will do, we can give less of time, because from these topics, just one or two questions will be asked. So this is how your strategy should be. Always follow a strategy for a particular exam, no matter whether you are preparing for TCS or any other competitive exam. Okay, so without wasting any time, let's get started. Just a minute, hold on. So I'm getting lots of doubts regarding that whether to give TCS May and QT or not. Well, it's your choice. Even I'm getting the question that whether TCS will hire or not. So we don't know, because TCS may hire or may not. As of now, there is no such commitment from the TCS side. But if your scores are good, if you have really done well, then yes, TCS can hire you. But as of now, there is no such commitment. So whether to go with the May and QT or not, it's all your choice. Okay, as if you can see in the October exam, even 19-20 pass out attempted the exam, and some 20 pass outs, I guess, got the opportunity for the interview because of their good performance. So nobody knows, maybe a chance that you can even got the opportunity for the interview itself if you have done well in the TCS May and QT. But talking about the commitment, so there is no such commitment from the TCS side that it's definitely going to hire. Okay, so that was the doubt that I want to clear in this video. Also, so now it is your choice whether you want to go with the TCS and QT or not. Okay, and those who are already selected for some particular role, that is Ninja or so. So by giving this test, your profile is not going to be updated, but your marks will be updated, right? So that is the case. Now I guess that all your doubts must be cleared. And those who are recently giving their interview in the TCS, so for them I have to say one thing, that guys, just have patience. Some students even wait for 1 month, 20 days, 25 days. So nobody knows that how long it will take for the interview completion or for receiving the mail or so. So the only option that you have with you is just to wait. Okay, so just wait for your chance. Just wait, just have patience. That is what you can do. I can understand the anxiety that we do have for the interview, that when my mail will come, when my mail will come. Even I was facing the same, so I can understand, but we have no other option except waiting. So just keep calm and wait for your chance. So that's it. So now let's quickly understand the most important topics and everything that we have to cover. So let's see. So here we are, and here we have categorized the topics as mostly asked, average occurrences, and really asked topics. Okay. So first, let's understand the topics that are mostly asked, and your kind of full concentration should be on these two categories, that is mostly asked and average occurrences, because most of the questions you will get from these topics only. So first focus on these particular topics, and then if you have the time, then you can go for the really asked as well. So it totally depends on you, but first cover these topics that I have mentioned in the mostly asked and average occurrences category. Also, what you can do, you can take the screenshot so that you can have in your mind that which topics I have to cover first. Well, the most important topic is that number system. Well, no matter which exam you are giving, whether it's even it's CAT exam also, number system, you're always going to get the questions. Very interesting topic it is. But the thing here is that, see, generally, if you will see the question from number system, so hardly it will take 30 seconds to solve the question. But the condition is that you should be aware of the concepts like as divisibility rule, cyclicity rule, and many others. Right, but if you are not aware of them, then 30 seconds won't work for you, right? So that is why you first have to understand the concept, you first have to understand the techniques, and from where, how you are going to understand those techniques. Well, we will also try to work on the videos regarding number system and other aptitude topics as well. What you have to do, you have to do the practice as much as you can. Okay, without practice, if you think that you will do good at the aptitude, then sorry, it is not possible, because it's need aptitude is a section, aptitude is a subject that needs a lots of practice. And even after practice, students do the mistake, and you are not even doing the practice, so you can think that what is going to be the result for you. Okay, so that is why you have to do the practice. Make sure that you first took the suppose you start solving the question from number system. Okay, you first took that particular topic. So first understand the concept, then solve the question. Without understanding the concept, you are directly jumping to the question. So yes, that's for sure. You won't be able to solve any of the question, and you will get easily demotivated. So first understand the concept, then go to the questions. And yes, there will be the question that you won't be able to solve. Look for the solution. Search on the Google is always there to help you out, right? Even you can search on the YouTube as well for the solution purpose. And there are certain videos also available. So if you are stucking at some particular topic, suppose you're not able to understand the concept of cyclicity, so first understand the concept, then jump to the question. See, you cannot memorize the thing here. If you're trying to memorize, then that is going to be harmful for you, because TCS question never repeats. Note it down. You can prefer the previous year questions to understand the approach, to understand the level of difficulty, to understand, to analyze that which topics are important and which aren't. But if you are thinking that question will be repeated, then sorry, it is never going to happen. So questions never repeated. So even after memorizing, you are doing the thing, so it is not going to work for you. Okay, so number system is very important. And also we will continue the next video on the number system itself. So wait for the video. And show your support so that we can continue, because it really took lots of effort to do the things, right? And if you are not even supporting, so that is sometimes demotivated, and we sometimes drop the idea. So make sure to support so that we can continue the series. Next topic is time and work. So time and work is also a very interesting topic, and you will love solving the questions from time and work. The condition is that, well, this topic doesn't have very much formula, so you don't have to worry about the things. Next one is averages, mixture, and allegation. So mixture and allegation is a topic that which concept you can implement, you can use on other topics as well. So that is why it is important, okay? And averages, yes, for sure, you will get the question from the averages. And these questions are going to be of basic type only, but the only thing is that you have to take care of the time and speed both, because at the time of solving the question from aptitude, time and speed both the thing matter. Next we have data arrangement, and then permutation and combination. Well, permutation and combination have certain formulas that you should be understanding it according to this situation. That is the formula we have to implement according to this situation. That is the formula. So that is for sure important in the case of permutation and combination. Well, generally what we have analyzed, the thing is that hardly they will go to any such topic. So generally they can ask you, they will ask you questions from combination only, that if there are certain 12 people given, out of which 8 are girls and 4 are boys, then you have to select 2 boys, 6 girls. So these sort of questions you will definitely get, and generally they will ask you these kind of questions only. Maybe a case that they are asking some sort of tricky question from the topic by mutation and combination, but rarely it will happen. We'll see, we'll understand the level of the question, so no need to worry. Next we have is that the topics that average that is having average occurrences. So first of all we have ratio and proportion, right? Next one is profit and loss. Well, I should say that this is the topic where lots of students basically hate this one, profit and loss. Well, yes, because even after solving lots of questions, you may be a case that you are not able to solve the question at the time of exam. Okay, so that is a very important topic and a kind of difficult one as well. So you have to do the lots of practice. Only then you can get the command of profit and loss. Okay, next one is percentage. But you know that why these students hating the subject? Because they are not first covering the percentage topic and they are directly jumping to the profit and loss. Because profit and loss, you will have lots of questions having the percentages. Well, I don't think the teachers won't ask will ask these sort of percentages, but may be a case that it can ask. So suppose if you are having 33.33% loss, so aadha time to aap isko fraction mein convert karne mein nikal doge if you are not clear with the percentage. Other time to aapne isi mein gaib kar liya, until then time will get over. So that is why percentage is very, very important. You should be knowing that 33.33% in ratio is 1/3. Okay. And for example, this is the percentage given, then you should be knowing that what it is mean. That is 1/7. Right. So you should be aware of this. And when you will be aware, when you are solving first percentage, then profit and loss. Students, what do you know what they will do? First, they will start with profit and loss, and percentage, they won't even care about percentages. And then they will say, I hate profit and loss. So first you have to cover percentage, then profit and loss. In the sequence, you have to do the things, not randomly just choosing any topic and solving the questions. Next one that we have is time, speed and distance. Well, this topic has formula speed equal to distance into time. And just by using that particular formula only, you will be able to solve all the questions. All the questions, really some cases will be there where you have to use some other formula. Well, this particular formula will also be derived from this one only, but this formula is the base of this whole topic, that is time, speed and distance. And usually, yes, for sure they ask the question from that particular topic. Next one is probability. Very, very important topic, probability for sure. Next one is ages. Ages questions are generally very, very easy. Very easy. I don't think that anyone will do this particular question from this particular topic wrong. Okay. It's because questions are going to be very easy. Just a simple thing is there, that when Meena was 6 years smaller and 6 years younger, these sort of questions, right? And clocks, well, they don't ask questions from clocks now. So you can just remove this topic. That's not important. Okay. So these are the topics that you have to put focus on. That is from the mostly asked topics and this average occurrences topic. Next one is rarely asked. So rarely they will ask you questions from logarithm. Okay. But make sure that you're aware of the formula that we do have in logarithm, so that if they're asking any questions, so that will be just formula based only. So if you're aware of the formula, you will be simply able to solve the question. From progression, that is arithmetic progression. And so will they ever used to ask the question from arithmetics or progression? But nowadays, according to new pattern, what we have analyzed, that they really asking the question from progression. Cubes and cubewards also a really asked topic, and same apply on the geometry and mensuration as well. So this is what is the proper analysis and the proper syllabus that you have to follow to ace your TCS NQT aptitude section. And believe me, aptitudes is very, very important. If you are doing really well in the aptitude, so then for sure you are around 80% selected 80% I'm telling, because rest percent depends on other section as well. Okay, so that is what I'm saying, because generally what happens, verbal everyone can do, because this is sort of easy. Verbal everyone can do. Reasoning is also kind of easy, but where there's a competition in the programming part, and then in the aptitude part, and mostly in the aptitude part, because what we have noticed that TCS gives kind of less preference to the coding part, right? So that is the thing. So make sure to follow a proper strategy and give as much time as you can to the aptitude part. Even if you are giving 1 to 2 hours daily, that's more than enough. Just make a plan that I will give around 1 to 2 hours daily to the aptitude section from today itself, from April to the May itself. And then TCS is all yours. Just 1 month do the effort. 8 mahine mehnat kar lo. And then result it will be in front of you. Okay, so that is the thing. With selection ke baad, then we will see that how to do the interview preparation and all. We will do the video on that as well. Already we have one video on that. But this aptitude is very, very important. So that is it for this video. I hope this video has helped you a lot and help you understand that what topics should be focused for. See, strategy matters a lot. You must have seen that many students are putting the effort, but they are not getting the resultant outcome. Why? Because they are not doing the things in a proper strategy. Randomly they are doing the things, कुछ भी कर रहे हो, कोई सा भी टॉपिक उठा रहे हो, अब आप पूरा टाइम अपने लॉगरिथम में दे रहे हो एंड लॉगरिथम से क्वेश्चन आता नहीं, सो व्हाट इज द प्रॉफिट ऑफ डूइंग द थिंग्स? नो प्रॉफिट इज देयर, राइट? सो दैट इज व्हाई यू हैव टू फॉलो अ सर्टेन स्ट्रेटजी दैट वन बाय वन आई हैव टू कवर ईच एंड एवरी टॉपिक. ओके, सो दैट इज द थिंग. सो थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो. मेक श्योर टू लाइक द वीडियो, मेक श्योर टू सब्सक्राइब द चैनल. And do this video with your friends as well who are having and who are thinking of giving the TCS main entry. So make sure to share the video with them. And bye bye. Do join us at our Telegram channel. Bye bye. Keep learning.